see. So after months of recruiting, taking out personal ads, and opening a profile on OKC, you can imagine my frustrated heart when this year I realized I would go back to the start of my very first encounter with how miracles can occur. It started when I was about 12. You guys were a blur. But I'll tell you the story now, because this is certainly some supreme pride. You'll never guess how this lesbian went from deeply conservative to changing the tides of equality and making sure that justice is served. My friends, give ear to how this victim became a survivor, both seen and heard. I've only ever fallen in love with one man, but as you can readily imagine, he was the kind who would give his life and exist solely to help me through strife. He was a savior of the very best kind, and from everything I read, he had healed the sick and the blind, so surely he would be my lifelong friend, and in him I would find salvation, and our love would transcend all the bullies and all the pressures of my teenage years, and he would comfort all those secrets and hidden tears. Well, even though I never actually met the man, because he was much older, I saw him as someone who would never give me the cold shoulder, so all these years later, when I couldn't find myself a suitable prom date, I thought for sure Jesus would make a perfect mate. Savior for hire, like a matchmaking service. I thought, I'll shoot him a text and see if he can deliver us. Hey, J-Man. I know it's been a while, but I got this event. And I could really use a wingman. A presence like yours would be heaven sent. Sending. Imagine my surprise when he didn't respond right away. I thought, shit, he's probably heard that I'm gay. And then I remembered all those meetings and those sessions when those close-minded cult leaders shared their lessons about how homosexuality was a sin and I, as one of God's possessions, couldn't follow my natural desires toward the same gender because such areas of gray would be like tossing truth into a blender, mixing my personal experience and what felt natural with 2,000 or biblical mandates from 2,000 years ago. Dare I be so casual about my sexuality and spiritual journey? Good grief, I just text Jesus. What the hell's wrong with me? Oh, Christ, I gave you a back. Let me check my phone. He did. It's him. I think my cover's blown. Should I check it? Hey, girl. Got your note, but I don't think I'm your type. It's not you, it's me. But don't believe all the hype. I'm totally down with that lesbian thing. Believe me, I was there. I came and I saw how a woman can tug a heartstring. Those girls be fierce, but you gotta love them. So sorry, people who say they know me keep calling it a sin. Anywho, your event sounds awesome, but I got some godlike shit to get done. So, go ahead and check in with Kali, Shakti, and Isis, and have yourself some fun. Oh, there's a P.S. P.S. Tell those GSA youth I got their backs in the next three elections. Oh, and somebody get some damn cliff notes about what I said. Love one another, and let the dead bury the dead. Enough said. Well, I wasn't sure if Jesus was from the ghetto or if he was just trying to be hip, but either way, I'm fine being here alone with whatever goddesses show up and offer me a sip from the fountain of youth and promise for all that this year and every year we can answer the call, not to find the perfect date or the spiritual path, but to accept that we are loved just as we are. And laugh until we cry, and cry until our stories are made clear. We are all survivors of many things the last 5 years. So ask me about supreme pride and how anything can happen, And I'll tell you that on much more than a whim, we've orchestrated something as important as the Second Coming with our rainbow flags, GSAs, spoken words, and dancing. This is our fifth year telling PwC to wake up and smell it all, equality's brewing, because LGBTQ youth, their allies, and apparently even Jesus, doesn't care who we're screwing. I've learned anything can happen since I was just a young lizzie. We are the miracle workers, the ones who are changing history. Every time we let the love flow from the schools to the courts and from the churches to professional sports, we walk on water and we give sight to the blind and those who can't see. We are the saviors that we are looking for on the path to civil liberty. Thank you.